the latest in tech and accessibility. This is Access Tech Live with Stephen Scott and Marc Aflalo.
Hey everyone, welcome back to Access Tech Live with me, Stephen Scott, and Marc Aflalo this week. Now, Ottobock is a Canadian company that has been pioneering prosthetics for over 100 years. Jennifer Duke is the Senior Marketing Manager for North America at Ottobock and joins us now from their headquarters in Burlington, Ontario. Jennifer, welcome to the show. Tell us the Ottobock story that began way back in 1919, I believe.
Yes, thank you. Thank you for having me today. We're actually a German company that started in 1919. So our Canadian office is located in Burlington, Ontario, but they started by the owner, Ottobock himself, started the company in Berlin, and they started manufacturing components. And the idea was to help veterans coming back from World War I to get back to mobility. And from there, they had to move the facility just due to like political unrest. The company is now located in Duderstadt in Germany. It was taken over by his son-in-law, Dr. Max Nader, in 1947. And since then, has been passed along to his son. So it's still a family-run company, manufacturing many prostheses and orthoses for people all over the globe. So it's a global company.
Jen, we talked off air so many times leading up to this conversation about the company, and I don't think we'll be able to do it justice in terms of talking about all the positivity you guys are bringing into the world. So I want to dive into a question for you, you know, about prosthetics themselves. I'm curious how they're made to feel as much as a real extension of the human body as possible, because every experience must be different, right?
Absolutely. Two things to remember with prosthetics are like socket fit and alignment. Those are so important for our customers when they're looking after their patients. But everyone's experience is different. And what's important is that the patient finds the right device for them. It's not one size fits all. Everyone's lifestyle is different. There may be someone who's recently gone through an amputation and prior to that they were a runner, so they want to get back into running, or maybe they want to take up a sport. So it's really important that a proper assessment is done and the patient trials the unit. That's something that we offer too. They're free trials, so they have patients have the opportunity just to sign up and work with their prosthetist. We have a professional clinical services team as well that works with them to ensure that they've got the right unit for them.
Can I ask about how technology impacts this industry?
Yeah, so we are constantly reinvesting in R&D to develop new products, and some of the latest technology comes from, you know, our initial microprocessor knee that we launched called the C-Leg. That was launched in 1997. It was actually developed by a Canadian, Kelly James. Ottobock acquired the patent. And since then, the rest of our microprocessor knees have developed based upon that. It really is a revolutionary product. It stimulates natural gait. It's intuitive. It's safe, super safe. It offers like a stumble recovery mode. And it's just got this intuitive stance feature as well. But since then, we have, you know, the X3, which is a fully waterproof device that was developed for the military. It is now available for civilian use. It's come a long way. Even myoelectrics, Max Nader introduced the first myoelectric arm. So hands, microprocessor hands and elbows. It comes back to really feeling like the real thing, you know, that it gives the user the opportunity to do the things that they either used to do or even just those everyday things that they don't have to stop and think about it. You know, the difficulty of tying up shoes or feeling safe while they're cooking and standing at the stove.
So is that the real difference between having a microprocessor or a computer-enabled prosthetic versus something that doesn't? Is it about the real kind of feedback, the more natural feeling to it? Is that what sets them apart?
For sure. So it's intuitive. So someone, if you think about the amount of work that your brain does in order to allow you to make certain movements, if you have to constantly think about where you're walking, what kind of terrain you're walking on, are you going to catch your toe? That puts a lot of stress on you cognitively, right? So, and even on your sound side, sometimes your sound side will compensate for those movements, whereas a microprocessor knee is doing that for you. So it's a lot more intuitive.
So something that caught our attention was the clinic you set up at the Paralympics, and you do this every year, and Greg Westlake made reference to it just a few moments ago. What is that about? Is that all to do with commitment to the Paralympics, the passion for the Paralympics? And tell us a little bit about what you do there.
Yeah, so this is something that we have been committed to since 1988. It's the passion for Paralympics, and we are the technical sponsor for the Paralympics, which means that we set up on-site technical support staff that are there to support the athletes when they're coming off the track, if they need support with their wheelchairs or their prosthetic devices. So we know how important it is for an athlete to be able to get back into action and compete. And they've worked so hard to get there that we need to ensure that we're there to get them back at it. It's almost like a pit crew, you know, in racing. It totally is. And there's a lot of energy on site. We also set up shops close to the athlete's village. So that, you know, if they need help with even just their everyday prosthesis, we're there so that they can, you know, truly feel the full experience of the Paralympics. But Paris is coming. It's next year. We're there. We're super excited to be a part of that. So, we've been committed to this for years, and we continue to moving forward.
Now, the peace of mind, I'm sure it does to the athletes as well, to know that if something happens, they're not just out of it. They can actually get it fixed and do something on the spot. Yeah. is so incredibly cool. And, you know, I'm looking forward to the episode Level Playing Field next week, because it dives into a lot of the process and stuff and everything that you do. And as I said at the top, we could talk for an hour and probably not get through some of the stuff that you guys are doing. But what is upcoming? What kind of projects are you guys working on when you look down the road?
We always have new projects that are launching, and we're building upon reinvesting in R&D. We have, you know, new mechanical knees, upgraded microprocessor knees. We just launched the Taleo Adjust Foot, which is like a carbon fiber foot that has an adjustable heel, which is pretty awesome. Many people wear higher heeled shoes, so it allows the user to do that. We have a quick change adapter, which allows the user to switch out. You know, they can switch feet, they can switch knees. If they want to get into their running knee, or if they want to switch over to those high heels, they can do it instantly and not take up a lot of their time. We also, I know we produce a lot of prosthetics, but we also produce orthotics as well. And the C-Brace is a microprocessor knee, ankle, foot orthoses. And we've seen a lot of really good results come from it. So we're continuing to make people aware of all of the options that are available. So just stay tuned. There's always a lot going on.
Yeah, it sounds like it. And honestly, I wish we could talk to you more. But the good news is you are going to be on Level Playing Field talking about all of this next week. So we look forward to that. Jennifer Duke, thank you so much for joining us here on Access Tech Live this week. If you want to know more about Ottobock, you can follow them on Instagram, Facebook, and LinkedIn as well. Just look for Ottobock_North America. And of course, you can also visit ottobock.com.
And of course, that Level Playing Field episode is Tuesday at 9:30 p.m. Eastern on AMI TV, and of course, the AMI Plus app. And of course, you can tune in whenever you want on AMI TV. Coming up, Mike Buckley joins us, the CEO of Be My Eyes, to break down how the OpenAI announcements affect their company. Stick around. This is Access Tech Live.
We want to hear from you. Follow us on social media and get involved at Access Tech Live. We'll be right back.